Have you listened about that story, Jessica?
I didn't listen. I came when you were drawing. When you were drawing some line, it was there was already a line on the screen, a shorter one. You were drawing a long line on the screen.
Okay.
That was when I came.
Okay. Neha, can you speak or you are in a listening mode only? Neha. So you are in a listening mode. Maybe you are listening. Okay. Right. Suppose I drawn one line. Yashika, listen. I drawn one line and without touching it, I asked you to make this line shorter. How you do it?
I draw a taller line.
You have to draw one more parallel line which is bigger than this one. Then yeah. If you ask me which line is shorter, I have to say the line drawn by me will be shorter. Isn't it? Yashika?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now whether this line drawn by you is a longer or shorter?
It's the longer line.
How can you say it is longer line? This line is not there. Suppose I have not drawn any line. Then whether this is shorter line or longer line?
I can't tell you. You have to draw another line.
You can't say absolutely whether this is longer line or shorter line. But you can say when you compare it with one more line, isn't it? Yashika, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So in the same way, motion and rest are also absolute. That means you can't say this object is in a state of rest or motion. Certainly. That means absolutely you can't say this is in a state of rest. Why? Because if one object is in a state of rest according to one person, it may be in a state of motion according to another person. So that's why it is relative. So when it is a relative, by comparing, you have to say whether it is in a state of rest or motion. Maybe one example I gave here in this particular question. Passenger sitting in a moving train are in a state of motion with respect to platform, but the co-passenger who is sitting in your train will be state of rest with respect to you, isn't it? Have you got my point, Yashika? Yashika, have you got my point or not? Are you there? Can you listen me or not? Right. Pragya? Are you there, Pragya?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Right. Types of motion. Okay?
Okay, sir.
You unmute. What is that sound? Mute it. Right. Now let us learn about different types of emotion. How many types of motions are there? So do you know how many types of motions are there?
Sir, yes.
Tell me how many types of motion will be there in our daily life generally?
Sir, there is circular motion, translatory motion, linear motion, random motion and oscillatory motion and rotatory motion.
Okay. So Neha, tell me how many types of motion will be there generally in our daily life? Fawaz, you are not giving any answer. Tell me how many types of motion will be there generally in our daily life? Are you listening, Fawaz? Motion rectilinear. Right, then tell me how many types of motion will be there generally. Right. What, Neha? No, don't means what? Right. So Pragya said about different types of emotion and generally three types of motion will be there. Those will be called translatory motion, rotatory motion and oscillatory motion. Three types of motion will be there and about them we are going to learn today, right? And first type of motion will be called translatory motion. And what is translatory motion? And what is rotatory motion? Those things we are going to learn. So now see here. First one, translatory motion. So the motion in which all the particles of the body move through the same distance in the same time is called a translatory motion. Right, Neha? Okay. So translatory motion means what? If all the particles of the body move through same distance in the same time, it's called what? Translatory motion.
Translatory motion.
Okay. That means suppose if you are moving from one point to another point, suppose from here to here you are moving. Now your total body will move, or your leg will be there here and your body will move here?
So my total body will move.
That means total body, if it is moving from one point to another point, then it will be called translatory motion. Have you understood? Suppose if car is moving, this is car, and car is moving from one point to another point, then total car will move, or only some part of the car will move from one point to another point? Pragya? Total car will move.
The whole car will move.
So when whole car is moving from one point to another point, then it is called which motion? Translatory motion. So as a total body, it has to move from one place to the another place. Now let us learn about few examples related to it. And first one is a car or train moving along road or track. So those generally will be nothing but what? Translatory motion. So car is moving along a track.
So it's translatory motion because the whole car is moving.
Very good. Okay. Now a ball rolling on the ground. Total ball will move, or only some part of the ball will move?
So the complete ball will move.
The whole ball will move.
So that's why it is also translatory motion or not?
And so fire, it will come in translatory motion.
Right, firing of a bullet from gun also translatory motion. Why? Because total bullet will move.
So the complete bullet will move together.
So a stone hurled from catapult.
Sir, it's rectilinear motion. A stone from a catapult is surely rectilinear motion because the whole stone is moving.
Whole stone is moving. In translatory motion, again, different types will be there. The first you say stone hurled from catapult will be translatory or rotatory or oscillatory?
It's translatory.
Because as a whole total move. An apple falling from tree also.
Translatory.
Why? Because translatory. Right. A striker on the carom board going straight and hit the coin.
That's also translatory.
Right. So you are learning about the translatory. Different examples were given, but you have to understand one point. If object totally moves from one point to another point, then it is called translatory motion. And in translatory motion, again, two types will be there. Rectilinear motion and curvilinear motion. How many types will be there? Rectilinear motion and curvilinear motion. So what is rectilinear and what is a curvilinear? That we are going to learn now.
Okay, so,
sir. When an object moves along straight line like a ball dropped from a height, the motion is described by the body is called rectilinear motion. That means an object totally has to move in a straight line like this. Then it will be called what? Rectilinear motion. That means along a straight line it has to move. Then it will be called rectilinear motion. Now see here, a ball rolling on the ground. Ball rolling will move like this. It will be a straight line like this with a slope. So then it is nothing but a translatory motion. As a whole, ball is moving from one point to another point. and here car moving on a straight road, so car is moving from one point to another point. Now here also as a whole car will move, that's why it is also translatory, and apart from that, as it is moving along a straight line, it will be called rectilinear. And a stone falling from the roof of the building, that means if stone is there here and dropped here like this, then also it will be called rectilinear. Rectilinear means you have to understand that it is moving in a straight line. Okay,
so rectilinear, it's moving in a straight line, and I'm just guessing that curvilinear motion is that it moves in a curved line.
Okay, so it is nothing but what? Rectilinear motion. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Right. Now let us learn about curvilinear motion. And when a body moves along a curved path, the motion is described by body is called curvilinear motion. So in curvilinear also, total object has to move. But how it will move? It will not move in a straight line like this. Instead of that, it will move in a curved path like this. It may be rotatory, it may be circulatory, it may be like this also. It will be moving in a curvilinear manner like this. It must not be a straight one. But as a whole, object will move from one point to the another point. So see here, a body thrown by a boy from height. Suppose here you are throwing one object from some height. Then what happens is this body as a whole will move like this. It is not moving along straight line. It is moving like this. It will look like a curvilinear one. And a car moving along a curved path, that is also curvilinear. A javelin shot put thrown by an athlete, javelin or shot put. Now generally javelin, if you throw, it will go like this. Maybe you observe it, isn't it? Whether it moves in a straight line or like this, it will move. It will move like this only, no? Pragya.
Will not move
in a straight path. It will curve a little, so it will be curvilinear.
Right, it will be curvilinear.
Sir, what's a javelin and an athlete?
Javelin, athlete. Athlete means generally who will participate in games. Now, suppose the runner is there. Okay. Running game will be there, no?
Okay.
Running game, and who is participating in it, that will be called athlete. And generally in some of the sports events, javelin throw will be there. Javelin throw, do you know, maybe in some movies also they will show one stick will be there, very long stick will be there, and for this a sharp knife will be there like this. And they will throw it by holding it. And that particular javelin throw, who will be thrown by it, that person will be called athlete. Okay? The person who is releasing that javelin, so he will be called athlete. Shot put also. Maybe you know about shot put also. So those things will be thrown by athlete. And when they throw, definitely it will move like this. It will not move in a straight line like this. So it is also curvilinear motion. A ball thrown upward at an angle. So if you throw ball at an angle like this, it will move. You can see yourself after completing the class. A car or train moving along curved road or a track are all examples of curvilinear motion. But remember here, in curvilinear motion, total body will move or only some part of the body will move?
Here also it's a part of translatory, so the whole body will move.
And some part of the body will not move. Total body will move, but they are moving in a curvilinear. That means not straight. If it is straight, it will be called rectilinear. If it is curved one, curvilinear motion. So this is about translatory motion. Now let us learn about rotational motion. And rotational motion means what? A motion in which a body moves about a fixed axis without
fixed axis, sir.
called rotational motion. Right. Tell me, Pragya.
Sir, I was just saying in rotatory motion, and a body moves along, I mean, a body moves on a fixed axis. It moves on a fixed point.
Okay. Now, see here. Now, generally, you can see about a fan. What the fan will do? Fan will rotate about a axis. Center axis will be there for the fan or not?
Sir, it will be there.
Right. And without changing its position, it will move in a circular way or not?
Sir, it will move in a circular way.
Right. So that is called rotational motion. That means if any object is moves about a fixed axis without changing its position, then it will be called rotational motion. Without changing its position, it has to move. Okay. Without changing its position, it has to move, then it will be called rotational motion. So the motion of the blades of a fan are rotational motion or translatory motion?
Sir, according to me, it will be both.
Translatory will be there.
Sir, I think both will be there.
Why both will be there?
Rotational,
because the blades of the fan are moving around the central axis, and they are moving in a like a circular path, so it will be both.
Now see again. Observe carefully, Pragya, whether total fan is moving from one point to another point.
Sir, no.
When fan is not moving as a whole, how can you say it is translatory?
Sir, a complete blade is moving as a whole, so I'm talking about one single blade.
Complete blade is moving, but fan is moving. Fan is not moving, no, from one point to another point.
No, sir.
Right, so then definitely the blades of the fan are having which motion? Only rotational motion. Why? Because it is moving around a fixed axis only. It is not moving from one point to another point, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Right. The wheel of a sewing machine, definitely it is also a rotatory motion. A giant wheel. Now, giant wheel is over here.
Are the hands of a clock an example of rotational motion?
Yeah, definitely. Why? Because it will have a fixed axis, no? By fixed point, it will move like this. Rotational motion only, no?
Yes, sir.
Right. A spinning top. So, like this top will be there. One spinning top will be there, and for that spinning top, one axis will be there like this. And around this axis, it will rotate like this. Isn't it? Without changing its position, it will move around this particular axis. So, spinning top also will be rotational motion. A spinning wheel, charka, whatever is there, that is also which is used by Gandhiji more. That charka is also is an example of what? Rotatory motion. And rotating potter's wheel, that means who will make parts. Wheel will be there at the center, some axis will be there, and around it will rotate. So all these will rotate around a fixed point. That's why it is called rotatory motion. Now observe carefully. Whatever tires will be there for a bus, whether they will be having rotatory motion or translatory motion?
Sir, rotatory motion.
Very good. So the tires of the bus will have a rotatory motion. That means some fixed axis will be there, and around it will rotate. But apart from that particular rotatory motion, tires of the bus will have translatory motion also. Why? Because when bus is moving, as a whole, wheel also will move or not?
The whole bus is moving, so the whole bus is moving,
wheel also move as we're part of it then.
Right,
the wheel, therefore, they move in a circular motion.
Right.
But, sorry, the rotating motion. But
But because the whole bus is moving, it's translatory motion.
Right. So that means total bus is moving from one point to another point. That's why the whatever the wheels of the train are there, they will be in a rotatory motion as well as translatory motion. So I'm giving few examples which are having different types of a motion. Okay, now let us learn about circular motion. When a body moves around a circular path, the way an athlete runs around a circular track, such motion is called a circular motion. So when a body moves around a circular path, then that particular type of a motion will be called what? Circular motion. And what is the difference between circular motion and rotatory motion?
Sir, in circular motion, the whole body moves as a whole from one point to another in a circular path. And in rotatory motion, and a body moves around a certain axis.
Right.
In a circular path.
Right. See here. Now, suppose, for example, one ground is there, and in the ground, some track is there like this. And this is the center point. On the track, one athlete is running like this. Now, by taking this as a fixed point, he is rotating around it. Now, he will be in a circular motion or not? So, he will be in a circular motion. Why? Because he is moving in a circular path from a fixed point. So, that's why it is called circular motion. And similarly, blades of the fan will be rotatory. Why? Because they are not changing their position. But as a whole, fan will move in a circular path about a fixed axis. That's why it is called circular motion. So motion of an electric fan will be circular motion. And motion of a merry-go-round, that means now generally maybe you know that in some kind of what we call exhibitions, some play will be there in which it will rotate around itself like this.
Sir, in a carnival.
Huh?
Sir, in a carnival.
In a carnival, it will be there. Merry go round. It is also one kind of a sport only, or one kind of a.
Yes, I know merry go round. There will be horses like horses or ponies or something.
Right, right.
And children will sit on it and the horses will rotate.
Right. So that will be merry go round and it will be there in exhibition generally. Or carnival, like that will be there now. And that is also a circular motion. And motion of a spinning top also will be circular motion. Motion of a earth around the sun, that is also.
So I didn't get the difference between circular motion and rotatory motion.
So we are going to learn about it in the next slide. Okay.
Okay.
Right.